everyone. My name is Chinmayee Chetna Dash. I've just achieved my biggest achievement for being topper of Odisha Civil Services Examination. I've been preparing since 2015, and this was my first attempt in Odisha Civil Services Examination in 2016. And my strategy was to cover each and every topic and all aspects of it, starting from prelims and mains. Next, I dedicated like 6 to 7 hours mostly so that I don't have, you know, much frustration and all that. I'm studying 12 to 13 hours and I'm not gaining anything. So the 6 to 7 hours that I put in, I expected quality work from it. I organized like in 1 hour I'll complete this much topic or this much subject on this subject. So then I scheduled my timing to that only and I completed it. So that was a rigorous routine also, and 1 hour I kept for newspaper reading because newspaper you have to go through thoroughly. And I organized each and every hour for each and every topic. I prepared a routine in the morning and then I started off like 6 to 7 hours concentrated. I concentrated on that topic. Since I was doing my M.Tech also sidewise, so I had to also do my thesis work also. So for that reason, the hours that I put in, I expected quality work from it. So prelims, I would like to say, there is one DK publication. DK publication, they have a concise of every question and answers and also synopsis of each and every subject. So if you go through that book, that is also helpful in your examination. And apart from that, for Odisha specifically, Odisha manual published by R1 classes, that is also very much precise and concise, so it's very much important for your prelims. So that you can go through. Rest, for your polity, there is Lakshmikant's book, which every aspirant follows, and that is very much important, but you need to know each and every aspect of it. After that, in your history, NCRT books are more than enough. There's no need to go for any other courses. Then comes your environment. Environment Shankar Rai's book is also there. But apart from that, NCRT books are also feasible for this. Then comes your geography. Geography, physical geography, fundamentals of physical geography, human geography. These are all of class 11th and 12th books. NCRT, that is more than enough. No other source is important that much. So that is the main part how you will clear your prelims. Then comes your mains examination, which is very important because you have to score good marks in it to at least clear the line and to get a rank. So for mains examination, I concentrated mostly on my optionals. History and geography were my optionals. And these two subjects also helped me in my GS preparation also because it covers much part in it. So in history and geography, go through the syllabus. Each and every topic in the syllabus is very important. You need to learn about it. And apart from that, when you are writing a certain answer in geography, if you can give certain recent examples of what happens in current affairs and all stuff, so that will be more attractive for the paper checker who is checking your papers. And apart from that, in GS studies, each and every question is important. You should not leave any question. And it doesn't also mean that you will bluff it out, but whatever you know, you try to write about it. And in essay, this essay paper is also very important. You need to cover each and every aspect of that particular topic. Like my topic was the growing internet connectivity. So I started from the history of internet connection to what the users in application and what are the modern facilities that we are getting from internet connection. So likewise, you have to cover each and every topic. And for your GS studies also, there are certain books that is available for geography. There is Majid Hussain, where you can study for your physical geography part from your GS studies. And for Odisha, there are certain books that is available in your bookstores also. For history of Odisha, one book is by author Panda. So he has also written a good work of that for Odia history. And geography is also available for, I think, the Kitab publication is there. So for that publication is mostly for your Odisha part, your history and geography. So you can consult for that. And rest your GS preparations, mostly go through the questions. Question and answer are also available in your bookstore. So there are copies that are available, you can go through it. And apart from that, there are certain materials also is available that Vajira materials are followed and Vision IS are followed for current affairs to correlate the examples and to write an exam. Online Vision IS current affairs, all the PDF is available online. And even if you are typing for it, certain ecology related, environment related, and even history and geography, certain pages are available online also for Vision IS. So they provide it freely. So that also you can download, and that is also very much useful. And also previous years, what I will say is that you have to start your preparation from your question papers only, because then you will get an idea of the framework, like what all questions can come in the examination. So for that reason, previous year UPSC question, try, and we know that solutions are also available over internet, so you can go through it. So So that you will get a framework like what to write, and then you can go through the study materials that is available from Vision Eyes also. So that is helpful. And R01 classes has also specially published one Odisha manual for Odisha history and geography, policy news. So in one book you will get everything. Economics also, this 11th and 12th books are there. NCERT books are there. That also has covered most of the topics. And apart from that, DK publication, as I told, they have given a synopsis of it, so you can go through that. And management, Visa publication and Chronicle, they also give synopsis of each and every subject in each and every month and all. For optional, like we know, Spectrum is there. Spectrum history books are available. Spectrum geography is available, and it covers most of the topics of the syllabus. Mostly, you have to go through all the topics of the syllabus and where it is available. So Spectrum is a very good choice because it has most of the topics covered. So, and if certain topics are being left out which is not there in that book, then you can search it in the internet also. But what I advise is that you have to go through the syllabus first. That is much more important than going by the syllabus of the book. The magazines which I refer to were Visa publication, because they give a synopsis of each and every subject, geography, economics and every issue. So you get a very good synopsis of every subject. So I follow Visa publication and Chronicle for current affairs, because they have a vast coverage of current affairs. And rest, online materials are available freely from Vision Eyes Current Affairs also. That is also a very good source, because you will get points regarding a certain bill or aspect, the advantages and disadvantages of it in a very elaborate form. And after that, your interview comes. For an interview, you have to be basically, they test how much confident you are when you are answering the questions. Because I was mostly asked about my professional background, because I am in MTech Construction Engineering and Management. So they tried to test me on that, and also they tried to ask me various questions regarding Vedas and Panchamrita and all stuff. Then they asked me about Odisha Public Works Department. So if certain people are dealing with certain contracts and all, because that is one of my subjects in my specialization thing. So what if a contractor does not obey the contract rules and all, what are the specification available to charge him? So they asked me on that. Then they also asked me what all areas I want to develop in Odisha where development is required. So I said I wanted to concentrate mostly on weaker sections of society, mostly like tribal regions, and also female development or empowerment I want to concentrate on. And also I said health sector, this national health survey was there, and Odisha was failing behind in this mortality rates and all infant mortality rates. So I want to concentrate on that. So they asked me about that also. After that, they asked me regarding certain normal GK questions, like where which river is found where, since my optional was geography, and which are the cities situated on it. Like for New York, they asked me on which river it is. They asked me about London, on which river it is. They asked me where Moscow, on which river it is. And they also asked me about the capitals of certain countries. And they also asked me about certain important personalities in history, because my optional was history, like Nelson Mandela and why he was famous. Then they also asked me about current affairs question, like State of Sina was arrested, so they asked me about that issue. They also asked me what problems the Chancellor of Germany was facing, even it was in current news. So these all topics they asked me. Then they also asked me about Vedas and all, what are the Vedas and how is it related and how it helps in your life, in human life. It is important to study Vedas. And also they asked me about Panchbhoot, what are the elements and all, and how is it represented in our life. But mainly they tested how confident, how calm I am, and so that is very important in interview. And I am very grateful to even R01 classes, because for the interview part, I totally concentrated on their interview strategies, so that is very much helpful to me in my interview preparation. And apart from that, I just want to tell every aspirant that it is not about how much hours you give in, but how much quality of work that you are getting. So if you are giving in 6 hours also, that should be a quality one, and you should be organized. Like if you know you are preparing for certain things, you have to first give certain hours to it, and you have to complete it within that time. So that is very important, your organization and how much you are giving, concentrating on that. So that is very much important. This is a very long process. The thing is, patience is very much required, because 2016 we gave the exam, and now the results are coming out. So it's a very long process. So at any time your patience should not break. And if you are also feeling down, and if you are also feeling that your hard work is not giving you results, just let that feeling go. With a fresh mind, you just start doing it, because distractions and all will come your way, and people will say a lot of things. Just don't hear to it. Just concentrate on your aim and you will achieve it. And if you put your hard work, you will definitely achieve it. No one can stop you. There is nothing called luck and all. It's all about your hard work. You are listening to BKT. I hope you like it. And if you like it, kindly subscribe it. And it's a very good channel, so kindly subscribe it.